In Metro Nashville, the increase in cases has prompted city leaders to roll us back to phase two of reopening. That means things you were able to do yesterday will no longer be allowed. We have team coverage tonight of what that means for you and your family. Let's start with News Channel 5's Chris Davis. Chris, what are the city leaders saying about this?
Well, Vicki, experts on the Metro Coronavirus Task Force say that we're really at a crossroads. We could continue going in the direction we're going. Thousands more could be infected or even die. That's why they're asking everyone to take a step back.
But I assure you, if we continue down this path, this will get worse and we will lose this battle.
When it comes to the roadmap for reopening, you might call this a detour.
Our phase three has not been effective. And we're going to go back to what we know is effective in slowing the spread of the disease.
The return to a modified phase two means that restaurants, gyms, and salons will have to reduce their capacity back down to 50%. Bars that sell more alcohol than food will have to close for at least 14 days. Social gatherings will have to be capped at 25 people.
None of this is being done to be punitive. These things are being done to save lives.
The task force called for a change in direction despite the fact a universal mask mandate was put into effect just days ago. Dr. Alex Jahangir likened the situation to emergency surgery.
If somebody's bleeding out, I'm not going to wait to see if maybe the bleeding would stop because I gave them some medicine. I'm going to do something in addition to that to prevent what is a really severe number of cases in a short amount of time.
Mayor Cooper also announced the city will be canceling the 4th of July fireworks scheduled for Saturday. Also on Saturday, a scheduled social justice protest. I asked Cooper if he hopes organizers will also cancel because of crowd concerns.
We may not be able to prohibit them, but we certainly want them to wear masks. We certainly want them to walk with their arms outstretched so that they're more than 6 feet apart.
But the detour may not have to last long. Dr. Hildreth reminded Nashvillians they're the ones in the driver's seat.
Personal responsibility. If each one of us does what we need to do, we can keep moving forward.
Of course, not everyone is happy with the task force's decision. The Beacon Center of Tennessee has released this statement saying, in part, the mayor has been completely inconsistent and derelict in his duty when it comes to enforcing existing rules, allowing some businesses to openly flout the law, and marching with large groups of people himself in violation of his own orders. Now, Cooper told reporters this morning they are not seeing evidence of these big protests leading to big outbreaks when they actually do contact tracing through Metro Public Health. We're live downtown tonight. Chris Davis, News Channel 5.